The sounds of continuous knocking on wood, and a strong scent of glue darkens the nose of the cross city alleys. The more the stepping between its ancient paths rose, the more clamor came from the workshops of engraving on thorn wood, of which no neighborhood was left. The people of Medina do not know themselves in front of any stranger except that they are the people of Arar, and the most skilled craftsmen in Morocco, who tweak wood panels to create unique decorations and carvings. In southern Morocco, 365 kilometers from the capital, Rabat, Fouja wood forests encircle the Moroccan city of Essaouira. On the shores of the Atlantic Ocean, Arar is not mentioned except in connection with this city. It is the source of livelihood for its people and the most important sectors of traditional industry upon which its local economy depends. It earned it fame among other Moroccan cities which also have Arar wood available, without comparing the quality of its products. Arar products in Essaouira and the skill of their makers. According to what a number of Arar makers in Medina told Anadolu news agency, Fouja wood has a distinctive smell that differs from other types of wood. Its forests are not found near Essaouira only, but rather extend to other regions in Morocco, but in Spain and Algeria and reach the Tunisian borders. But Essaouira is more famous for its engraving on Arar. The teacher Ahmed, 62 years old, says to Anadolu agency. Ahmed works in a workshop for the manufacture of Arar and has settled his shop in a small corner in the middle of the old Jewish neighborhood of Al-Mala, where there are many shops for the manufacture of Arar and shops selling its products. And he adds, and here in Essaouira, wood engraving has become not just a craft that most of the city's people practice, but a hobby that tends to be practiced even by the young. His hand movements step down and tilt with a noticeable smoothness as he steps on the wood panels stretched out on his table with floral patterns, flowers and tree branches. After he finishes the drawing, and by a quick successive method, he digs grooves on the wood, which do not settle into a specific shape until after weeks of continuous work. Engraving on thorn wood, and for its special nature, requires patience and patience from the craftsman. The conditions of this craft today do not tempt many, and the number of craftsmen is less than one day. Everyone is leaving to pursue more money. The teacher, Ahmed, says as he continues to carefully peck the wood, and he takes a look at his wooden board, to reassure that his engineering formations apply to those that you drew on paper. The Arar industry in Essaouira was linked to the urban development that the city witnessed in the mid-18th century, after the Alawite Sultan, Muhammad bin Abdullah, made it a prosperous city. It was once a loophole in a naval effort to repel attacks by Spanish pirates and invaders. And historical sources talk that the wood of Arar entered the city during this period, when it was used to build its walls and mosques, and it soon became an art and craft that became famous with the influx of a number of Moriscos to Essaouira from Fez Tetouan, northern Morocco. Muslims and Jews. What we earn from the juniper industry is seasonal and limited, linked to the tourist demand. For this small city, most of its people work either in fishing or in the manufacture of thorns. Its winds that blow cold coming from the Atlantic throughout the seasons of the year do not scatter through its alleys except for the smell of fish and thorn. Boucher, 44 years, a craftsman in engraving on thorn wood and sajil, organizes poetry in Moroccan dialect, is well known among the people of Medina. And his poem is not without him, as he tells of Anatolia, who sings his craft and narrates his attachment to pecking wood and drawing on his panels and engaging on it. Most of the craftsmen in the city of Essaouira, whom Anatolia met, fear the extinction of this ancient tradition due to the lack of raw materials. Although Arar occupies vast forests, especially in southern Morocco, but the depletion of this wealth has made the local authorities impose strict restrictions on cutting the thorn trees. The weakness of the incomes recorded by this sector from the traditional industry, according to the artisans of Al-Arar, made many people abandon the craft and join other crafts that are more prosperous and popular. As for the teacher, Ahmed, as he has been for years, he spends most of the hours of his day in his shop, his white suit being colored with brown thorn carpentry dust. Turns up in a cooler to remove every scratch that prevents his fearful table from becoming smooth to the touch. After completing the engravings, he goes to polish the surface of a juniper vessel. He does not leave for his home except when the wood of the vessel and the table shine brightly. He pulls them from inside the store to put them in front of him, all hoping that a tourist will fall on them the next morning.